So after a lot of contemplation on what to do, decided I gotta pull the radiator out from its location up here in the nose and move it back here. So I've marked out the location where it's gonna go. It's gonna have to sit up on top of the bed because the like rear end housing needs room to like travel up and down in there. I'm just gonna cut that out, and that's gonna be, I've measured this out to be the size of the radiator opening. So I'm just gonna have to cut this out and then set the radiator up here empty, and then add supports as needed, and then run the coolant lines all the way underneath the car. That was most of my hesitation, was the coolant lines. It's just not as simple as like running it directly to the radiator like this. You kind of gotta navigate a big aluminum tube through the car and make mounts, and it's a bit of work, but this truck had so much oversteer, I couldn't push it hard. Like truck had a lot more in it, and it just couldn't do it. It was just like spinning the back tires on entry and on exit. And it's, one of the ways to solve it is to like shift the weight from the front to the back, or add a rear wing. But that's kind of, you know, like the wing's good, but it's much better at speed than at the like low speed corners. So shifting the weight back from the front to the rear kind of helps all situations, and it's all the time. So it's even gonna help on the low speed corners, which honestly, that's where I've been having the biggest problem anyways, the low speed corners. All right, quick update. So I just started cutting this out and I forgot I was supposed to film it. So I punched out some like 1¾-inch holes once I marked out the location that I wanted. And just kind of, and that's what like gives it a nice radius when you're done, like that. It's just a lot cleaner than going to a point. It's a lot stronger too, stops it from tearing. So I punched out them holes, and now I'm just using it like a sheet metal cutter. So shear. So it like cuts out a 1/4-inch strip like this. It just naturally curls off. But yeah, I find that's the best way to make nice straight lines that you don't have to mess with too much. You know, like usually you just gotta clean up just the ends where it blends. That's about it. So this one's gonna be a bit of a pain. It's not just straightforward, just like cutting it all out. I'm gonna have to actually, I've got a brace underneath here, which that's what those rivets are. It sticks out about 2 inches or so, I think. So I gotta drill out these also, so when I cut through there. Oh, and I'm not gonna be able to run the shear just straight across either. It's gonna hit that. So I'm probably gonna come up like this and just kind of miss that initially, and then just deal with getting this corner off after that. Okay, so you can see this brace under here now. From here, I'm just gonna like cut up from the bottom, roughly where that line is, and just kind of like remove that piece from under there now. Yeah, these cut aluminum amazing. So I'm just gonna, run this along here, and that's gonna cut off that bottom brace. So we're gonna be finishing up with a die grinder with a used 50 grit, so it's not too sharp, and a used red Scotch-Brite. That mostly because I have just a bunch of used ones. All right, so it's all deburred, nice and smooth. And I'm just gonna clean off the Sharpie marks with some acetone. Gosh, I need to clean under here. I couldn't ever get to here. This is the one spot of the car where I couldn't really get to, so. This like drive shaft yoke was like kind of spinning oil all the way out under here. I don't know if you can see it sprayed on there. This thing's messy under here, so I need to get some degrees in the pressure washer back here. Clean back here a little bit more. But yeah, we got a hole all nice and smooth. And ready for to put the radiator in. Or on top of it. Yeah, so you can see here, this is a piece I cut out. You can see how this is all clean. Well, as clean as the top. But anyway, you can see on the bottom, that's being like spraying oil off of the drive shaft. So it's probably been dripping out of that front seal and just kind of spraying out. Yeah, so you can see up here, it's not much to pull this radiator out. I just got to pull these four rivets out the top here. I'll probably just pop that whole thing off because I won't be able to use that anymore. And I've got a drain down here at the bottom of the radiator so I can drain the coolant out, at least most of it. And pull those two hoses, the two main hoses. I've got this, this bleed hose from the steam ports that, I don't know, I'm gonna have to change the way I do that. And I've got this radiator cap that's upright. So it's kind of annoying because I won't be able to use that anymore. Unless I moved it to this front side. But yeah, then the only other thing I could do is unplug the radiator fan, pull this bad boy out, and just sit it back there. And I'm gonna have to clearance out for these hoses to go through. So I haven't cut that yet. I'd like to get it back there in place first because I want these to point downwards. But once this is mounted, then I can run the tubes, figure out what to do there. I'll probably just go buy like 20 feet of aluminum tubing, some bends and some like silicone joints, I'm guessing. That's kind of as far as I've thought into it right now. I'm not even sure where I'm gonna run them yet. I'm kind of just hoping that will become clear when I get under there. The like natural direction would be to point them straight down and go between the control arm and alongside the engine, missing the header, going outside that, and then just like running straight underneath. I mean, I'm gonna weigh this thing once I get it off, and then I'm gonna fill it up with water and weigh it again and just see how much weight I'm exactly moving, because this is it's a lot of work. So I mean, I know it's in the right direction, but you just don't know. It's good to know numbers. It makes you feel good about all the work you're doing. Yeah, so it's gonna help with like moving the weight to the back, which this car badly needs. Like this sheet metal, so heavy up here. And I've got the engine sat pretty far back. You can kind of see the gap between the radiator and the engine. It's pretty big, but I kind of originally built this truck as like a street truck. I just wasn't too worried about it. I kind of put it where it was convenient than where I should have. I mean, it's all a lot of work, but eventually have a car that can do good at the track. And yeah, so it's all worth the effort. If you get the car good, then you can drive a lot harder. It just feels better, feels safer. You can run faster lap times. All right, I got the radiator cleaned and stripped down. I put it on the scale too. The radiator by itself weighs 15 pounds. The water inside of it weighs about 10 pounds. And the radiator fan that goes on the back, you can see here my mounts. I've already got it taken off, but it weighs 5 pounds. It doesn't actually weigh as much as I was hoping. I was kind of hoping to shift more weight to the rear, but. So this is a calculator to like figure out if you move weight front to rear, the percentage changes. So if you see up in the top left,
This is actually calculated for like 2,800 pound vehicle with a wheelbase of 118, which is like roughly what I thought my truck weighs. I'm not actually sure. I haven't actually put it on good scales yet. And see, the top row is the percentage shift, and the left column is the pounds moved. So since this weighs 30 pounds and I'm moving it about 60 back, it's pretty much going to be a 0.5% front to rear shift. But as you can see, if it was like 60 pounds, I could have got almost a full percent shifted. So that's a step in the right direction, but still a long ways to go.
I got a notch now because I'm going to put these hoses pointing downwards. So I'm going to have to like notch these holes for these to poke through into the side here. Probably somewhere here and here. And then I gotta decide what to do with this radiator cap, because now it's pointed sideways. So I'm kind of debating on just lobbing off all the fittings and somewhat starting over, but undecided yet. I'm just gonna get it fitted in the car to start with. I'm gonna get some tubing ordered, some couplers, and continue on. Oh, also, because I've already modified this thermostat housing, you know, for this to point up, I'm gonna have to change that again too. So that's the other thing. But like, this is 1.5, this is 1.25 over here, the inlet and outlet, different sizes. So I'll probably just run 1.25 out 60 wall aluminum all the way back. It's nice to be pulling this weight off this nose. I've like still got the like oil cooler right here, and I have like air intake there. It's like a ram air type setup.
Can't see there. I got a filter.
Forcing a lot of air in there. I might get away from about both of these. You know, mount this on the floor maybe, a bit further back too. Behind the motor, and just do something different with this air intake. Or I may leave the air intake, but it'd be nice to be able to block off this whole grill, because I could stop all that air from entering. It'd be a lot better, because that's a big opening. Let's see, it takes in a lot of air, more than it needs to. I'm still gonna block off the bottom too. Yet to do that, and then make an actual splitter, because this was just my mock-up splitter. I just made it out of plywood and like sheet metal just to kind of get something there, but I'm actually gonna make that all out of composite. So this might be part of the mold. I might just start over again, I'm not sure, but I just needed to get something on there to kind of close out the bottom here. And when I was building it, I had always planned on changing it after. All right, so this is the hole I ended up with, this is what I had to cut out. So I've got the old lower one and then the upper, and then like this was the fan mount. This is to clear this fan here. Sticks out a little bit. Down in there, everything clears. See down here, got the openings around the necks going through. So she's sitting where I want her to now. So now it's just a matter of mounting it, and then I like figuring out what to do with all these ports. Accumulating pieces. I got the main run here. I got big bends that are gonna go around like through the control arm. And now I'm making the little short bends for up by the thermostat. and make another one of these. Probably by the end of this, I'll have freaking 5 of these made up. It'll take forever. I just tacked it. That's the hardest part, is getting them tacked together, but just because it gets so hot when you're welding it.